7:09 here on AM 1460, the new WXPR. You are listening to the Metro South Morning Show. Peter Zimbor and Mike Paver here with you on this Wednesday morning. This weekend in the city of Brockton, Friday night at the Buckley Performing Arts Center on the campus of Massasoit Community College, and Saturday night at Joe Angelo's Cafe in downtown Brockton. It's the second annual Shoe City Screens Festival, a film fest for filmmakers in the city of Brockton and surrounding areas. It's presented by Brockton Arts, Aaron Tebow, and Newbie Productions. And joining us now in studio to discuss from Newbie Productions is the one and only Newbie Ritteau. Newbie, good morning.
The award-winning Newbie Ritteau.
Bedman.
Newbie Ritteau already giving us his Shaquille O'Neal on TNT NBA pre- and post-game and halftime show coverage impression of the Birdman. Birdman.
I have a question. You said award-winning Newbie Ritteau. Now, this is a question for everyone out there listening. Silence is the award-winning film. That was a documentary we did 2 years ago. And we did win first place for that one. And we won a Silver Ace Award in Vegas, and we got
Silence.
Nominated.
Let's backtrack. Silence is a documentary film you produced about
the drug epidemic. Yes, Step Up, though, is, you know, and I love both films. I love them, but you know, Step Up has not won an award.
Step Up's infinitely
yet
better.
So the question is, am I still the award-winning?
Of course
you are.
Newbie Ritteau.
Once you win an award, you're always award-winning.
Always award-winning.
What if I never, ever win another award?
It's okay.
Award?
It doesn't matter. You still won an award.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll keep that. I'll keep that title.
It's like Weird Al will always be called the Grammy Award-winning Weird Al. Has he won a Grammy in years? I doubt it.
I'll keep it. Anyway, Peter, what's up?
Nothing much, Newbie. Tell us all about Shoe City Screens happening this weekend in the city of Brockton. First off, tell us how this event came to be. It's now in its second year.
I'll tell you something right now. You know, we did a whole, especially my team, Newbie Productions. Trevor on different film festivals. Went to Philly, went to Roxbury, New York, and so forth. And I'm like, you know, this is awesome. You know, great film festival. We have a great time. Like, you know, I want to do this in Brockton. I was talking to Aaron about him. You know, we should do some type of showcase.
Aaron Tebow, who was on our show on Monday.
Aaron Tebow, T-Boss, I call him. And then, you know, we're talking, you know, maybe, you know, how could we do this? So we say, you know what, there's only one person in the city that can really put this all together.
And who would that be?
That'd be Arnie Danielson.
He is the head of Brockton Arts?
Head of Brockton Arts. So we hit up Arnie, we'll get Arnie. We want to put a festival together. So, all right, cool, we're talking about it and everything. And then, you know what, we're talking about it. Then he said, you know, we should call it, in Arnie's voice, the Shoe City Screens. Come and play with us. So, that's my Arnie impression. So, all right, cool. That sounds good. You know, so last year we just did at Joe Angelo's with a whole bunch of shorts. Worked out good. You know what? That was nice, but we can amp it up. We could do a lot better. Andy Jasmine said, you know, Newbie, I want to be involved. Said, you know what? Cool. Let's make this happen. But you have a feature film. You know, I'm not sure if it'll fit on a Saturday. You know, Andy, since your film is so kick-ass, can I say that on air?
Yeah.
Since it's so, you know, kick-butt, well, it's too late, I already said
it's it. Kick-ass, you can say it. Say it again.
Since it's so kick-ass, since it's so badass, let's have your own night, Andy. I mean, this film is a Mandy. It's amazing. And
I was going to say a Mandy, it's a Barry Manilow song.
Yeah,
I don't know
Mandy.
What he meant by that.
It's amazing, and this film actually, I'm going to tell you something right now. If you go to a film festival, check that. If you go to a movie theater, right? Paver, let's just say you watch a Denzel Washington movie, right?
All
right,
yep.
When's the last time you watched a Denzel Washington movie, and then after the movie, get a chance to meet Denzel Washington?
That's never happened.
It's never happened, right?
Ever.
When's the last time you went to a Michael Moore or Spike Lee documentary movie? Let's say you watched, you know, what's a Michael Moore documentary?
Fahrenheit 9/11.
You watch Fahrenheit 9/11. When's the last time, Pave? I want you to answer this question. When's the last time you had a chance to meet Michael Moore after the film?
It's never happened.
Never happened.
When was the last time you watched a Michael Moore film, Mike?
I think it was Bowling for Columbine.
Really?
Or better yet, more recently. Let's just say
was before Fahrenheit 9/11. That's going back to the late 90s.
Let's just say you watch an ESPN 30 for 30. Oh, man, that was awesome. I want to meet the director. Well, that's not going to happen. You have that chance at Shoe City. That is giving you a chance to do that, to talk right to the director, right to the main actor. That right there is worth it. Especially if you want to be a filmmaker or you want to be an actor or be involved somehow in this industry, this is the place for you to go, Friday and Saturday. It's a no-brainer. That's a good deal, Peter. That is a very, very good deal.
We're chatting with Nubi Ritso here on AM 1460, the new WXPR Shoe City Screens Festival in Brockton this weekend. Friday night being held at the Buckley Performing Arts Center on the campus of Massasoit Community College. Saturday night being held at Joe Angelo's Cafe in downtown Brockton. Tell us the difference between night one and night two of the event, Nubi, and tell us how much it costs to get in and whatnot. How do you get tickets?
Okay, so Friday night, it's at 7 o'clock at the, excuse me, my voice is hoarse. You know why my voice is so hoarse? Sunday, I just want to backtrack a little anecdote.
I thought you were going into your Shaquille O'Neal routine for a moment. No,
my voice is hoarse because Sunday I was at the Cape Verdean Festival. And the music was so loud, I had no idea how loud I was talking. And then that night, I went out again, and then the music was loud again, and I had no idea how loud I was talking. Then the following day, I had to do training over at Brockton Community Access Cable, and I had to, talk out loud again. So my voice is a little hoarse, so I apologize to the viewers.
And then you had to go on The Mind of Mita, and you guys argued for a good 5 minutes. You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that. She lost her mind.
I thought you were going to end up on the floor.
No, yeah, Chimita's a little crazy. She definitely lost her mind. I don't know what's her problem. He could quote me on that. Yeah, she's a little crazy. We'll talk about that in a little bit.
Yes, all right.
But anywho, back to Shoe City Screens. So Friday night at Massasoit Buckley Performing Arts Theater, 7 p.m., we're showing the feature film Noah. And the main actor in that film is a Brocktonian. His name's Andy Jasmine. That's that. 7 o'clock at Massasoit.
Yeah, what is Noah? Is it a documentary, an actual movie?
No, it's an actual feature film.
Okay.
It's a feature film. It's about a slave living in the 21st century. Very, very interesting concept. And that was accepted at the San Diego Black Film Festival. It was accepted over at the Boston Independent Film Festival, prestigious film festivals around the country. So it's definitely getting a lot of buzz. So that's Massasoit, 7 p.m., and the main actor, Andy Jasmine, will be there. Excellent person to talk to network with, and some of the cast and directors will be there as well. Saturday, I call Saturday the All-Star Game. Saturday's when all the filmmakers come together with shorts and features and so forth. Saturday is going to start at 7 o'clock as well. That's at Joe Angelo's. Now, if you don't know where Joe Angelo's is, if you'll hear us, because we'll have DJ Big Tunes, who will be spinning from 6 to 7, just playing some music, getting the mood started right outside of Joe Angelo's. So 7 p.m. is when it starts, and we're going to start off with music videos, shorts, documentaries, and then we're going to end the night with my documentary, Step Up.
So should be a good time this weekend. Shoe City Screens Festival in Brockton. Second year you guys have been doing this event. Outside of the amount of days the event is this year as opposed to last year, what are some of the other differences from year one to year two?
Well, I think the quality of the videos is raised to a whole new stratosphere. We got so many outstanding pieces. I could tell with this a beautiful music video on Rocky Marciano, and that's combining hip-hop with music. So it's this footage of Rocky and footage of the artist's name, Manny Garcia. Excellent, excellent video. I think it's a nice Brockton feel of, how that new hip-hop generation is connecting with the old Rocky-type generation. We have a film that focuses on downtown Brockton on Hoagie's Hobbies. And Aaron Tebow filmed that. We have one on Stanley Bowman. So this film festival is a wide range of audience that's going to attract, because I could see someone who's 80 enjoying this and someone who's 20. So the quality of video is on a whole new level, and the diversity of video is on a whole new level. So should be a good time. And one last nugget. This will be the last time we're showing Step Up in the Brockton area as well at Shoe City Screens.
Now, you mentioned earlier the award-winning Nubi Ritso. Obviously, there is usually an award component to a lot of film fests. Not exactly the case with Shoe City Screens in its second year incarnation. Is that something you guys are ultimately working towards, or do you guys just want a straight film fest, allow people the opportunity to showcase their work in front of a larger audience?
that's the goal, Peter. We'll see. You know, we'll see how it goes this year. And I'm, you know, it's gonna go. It's gonna go excellent. You know, we'll see how the film shoots these screens, how it progresses each year. And the answer to that question is yes. I'm not sure when, but yeah, that's the ultimate goal. We want a full-fledged film festival, awards, and the whole nine.
You guys are doing it at Buckley Performing Arts Center this year, on top of doing it at Joe Angelo's Cafe. Both are excellent venues. Buckley Performing Arts Center, a little bit bigger for the big night Friday night, but both places a great place to hang out on a weekend.
Oh, man. I mean, Peter, tell you something right now.
Tell me.
For $10, $5 one day on Friday, $5 on Saturday, you get to watch really network quality films. For $5 and within a radius of 3 blocks. That's a good deal. That is a very, very good deal. You can't beat that deal. You can't beat it. If you can beat that deal, I want you to call and challenge that deal. And I will challenge you to a duel.
Someone's going to start a film fest and charge $4 tickets and just in spite of you, newbie.
That's a good. I mean, you know what? If that's the case, you know, we did our job. All right, cool. Next year's for free. No, don't say that.
Once again, we're chatting with Newbie Rateau here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. Outside of yourself, Aaron Tebow, and the folks from Brockton Arts, who else is involved in the organization, the Shoe City Screens Fest, and what goes into the organization of such a festival?
In terms of directors, Peter?
In terms of anyone involved?
In terms of everyone involved, the board of directors, I mean, I think it's about a dozen people. You know, Carl Landerholm is involved in Brockton Arts, Stephanie Danielson, Arnie Danielson, and so forth. In terms of directors who are involved in Shoe City Screens, we have Rui Lopes, who is one of the best undercover directors in Brockton. And I really mean when I say that. This guy, no one knows about him, but seeing his work, Peter, the guy is a beast. The guy is an absolute beast. And you'll see some of his work on Saturday. We have Bruno DePina, who does some work with BFMI, a local music group here in Brockton. Just an absolute beast. So the diversity in people, Peter, is like a plethora. Oh, nice word, newbie, plethora. Oh, man, too early for that, plethora, the nice word.
It's a word I use fairly often between 6 and 9.
It's one of Pete's favorite words.
Oh, well, I thought I was being pretty different by saying that. You should just, you know.
No, plethora.
You should just went on with it, Peter, and say,
oh,
no,
sorry. Well, I crushed your spirit.
If you listen to the show, then you'd know.
Yeah, I'm a little pissed off about that. That's okay. I'm not even mad anymore.
You listen every morning, 6 to 9, I thought.
Every morning, yeah. But I seem to always turn off the radio when you say plethora.
Newbie Rateau joining us here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. Once again, we're talking about Shoe City Screens this weekend in Brockton, Friday at the Buckley Performing Arts Center, Saturday at Joe Angelo's Cafe. Is there a website or something where people can get more information in relation to this event?
BrocktonArts.com has everything, or you can go on the Facebook page and type in Shoe City Screens. Either one of those two will get you the information that you need. But, you know, it's right there, Peter. 7 p.m. Friday, Massasoit Community College. 7 p.m. Saturday, Joe Angelo's Cafe.
Who's operating the Shoe City Screens Twitter account? They could step it up, newbie.
You know, Peter, I don't know that question.
They could step it up. They're not following back. They're retweeting, but they only get like 10 followers.
Pete's pissed.
I'm not pissed.
Yes, you are.
They didn't follow back, which I thought was kind of lame. So I unfollowed them.
Oh, so you unfollowed them?
I did unfollow them.
That's immature, Peter.
I was very petty with it.
See?
You don't retweet and then not follow back when you've only got 10 followers. That retweet did nothing. You have 10 followers. Step up your Twitter game, Shoe City Screens.
Hey, you know what? None good little competition.
That's right.
I like that.
That's right.
I like Peter's fire. He's a hot pistol. He's on fire right now.
I'm just saying.
Rant about something else, Peter. He's on fire.
There's a way to big time people, but when you got 10 followers, it's like, okay, well, that's just silly. Am I right, Mike?
Pete wrote the book on Twitter etiquette.
There's a Twitter etiquette out there. I'm learning more about Twitter etiquette as I go.
I'm a big Facebook etiquette person. When I text you and then you post a status, I'm a little mad.
Why'd you point at me?
Huh? I don't know. You know what? It's all about this girl. Yeah.
What's her name?
I'm not saying her name.
Oh, you don't want to get into this on the air?
I don't want to get into it on the air.
Sometimes we get into stuff and we just use fake names.
All right, let's just say her name is Jackie. It's not, but let's just say it's Jackie.
I was going to say, I know a Jackie, and you know a Jackie. She's hot. Not that yeah. Jackie. Not her?
No, no, not that. Oh, yeah. Oh, I wish. Anywho.
Hope the real girl's not listening. Continue.
No, so, you know, when you text somebody, you know, something, and you want a response, and you don't get a response, but you see on Facebook, they update their status, and it says, on Facebook now, Facebook is smart. It says if you update it with your phone or
right,
not.
By mobile.
By mobile.
Yeah.
So, obviously, you made it a decision to skip that text and to go on Facebook. That's a big slap in my face, actually.
So that happened with this Jackie?
Quote unquote, yes. So I was a little upset about that.
Have you spoken to her about this yet?
Absolutely not.
Should we call her on the air and get to the bottom of it?
No.
Okay.
I will probably never speak to her again in my life until she responds. That's just who I am. I'm that stubborn.
See, I feel the same way about the whole Twitter follow back thing. I understand where he's coming from. 726 here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. When you first got involved in Twitter, you were all about it. You've kind of gone back to the Facebook thing, Noby, I've noticed.
I'm more of an Instagram person, Peter, honestly.
I don't even have an Instagram.
Actually, no, I'm going to put this on Instagram right now. I'm going to take a picture of you, and then I'm going to post promoting Shoe City Screens on WXBR, and that will automatically go to my Facebook.
I can't wait.
I can't wait, too. My phone's a little slow.
727 here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. You are listening to the Metro South Morning Show. Peter Zimbor and Mike Pava here with you on this Wednesday morning. Remember, you can follow us on Twitter at PM in the AM Boston. You can like us on Facebook, PM in the AM, the Metro South Morning Show. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/PM in the AM Boston. Best place to hear archived interviews and content from this program. We're going to step aside for a quick breather. When we return, Mike Pava brings a local news update courtesy of the WXBR Newsroom. Newbie, you're going to stick with us, right?
Sure.
Newbie Rito is going to stick with us for another segment. We're talking Shoe City Screens here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. Happening this weekend, folks. Buckley Performing Arts Center Friday night. Joe Angelo's Cafe Saturday.
Stay with us.
You are listening to the Metro South Morning Show on the new WXBR 1460.
.737 here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. Peter Zimbor and Newbie Rito in studio.
Now, Mr. Mike Pava. When's a new WXBR just going to be the XBR?
It's a good question. Because eventually it's not going to be new anymore.
Yeah.
I'd give it a year.
I'd give it about today.
Today?
Yeah.
How about this? This Saturday is August 3rd, which is the one-year anniversary of something. What happened 1 year ago this Saturday?
The old WXBR shut its doors.
The old WXBR shut its doors. Went away for 7 months, came back. We're back better than ever. We're still here. And we'll be here next week, too, buddy boy.
Buddy boy! Shabba shabba woo!
7:38 here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. Peter Zimmer and Mike Pava here with you on the Metro South Morning Show, joined by Newbie Rito in studio. Remember, you can follow us on Twitter at PM in the AM Boston. Like us on Facebook, PM in the AM Metro South Morning Show. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/PM in the AM Boston. We're chatting with Newbie Rito about the Shoe City Screens Festival, a film festival in Brockton this weekend, Friday night at the Buckley Performing Arts Center on the campus of Massasoit Community College, and then continuing Saturday night at Mulligan's at Joe Angelo's Cafe. Newbie, describe your involvement with this year's event in terms of what films of yours will be showing. Is it simply Step Up? And the last time Step Up will be shown in the area?
Breaking news. Mike Pavey just friend requested me, so we're officially friends now. We weren't friends before, but Mike Pavey just friend requested me.
I mean, Mike's
been... It's about time, right?
Yeah, it's about time.
Even when you're not here, Mike yells Birdman.
Yeah, so we're officially friends now.
Come on, Mike. Birdman.
Birdman, Birdman,
Birdman.
Not only that, I brought in some Lunchables today, too, thanks to Newbie.
He was inspired by you.
We got to do the Birdman dance, too.
Let's talk about a few things. Number one, last time you were here, you brought in Lunchables, and we're eating Lunchables during the interview. And me and Mike were like, I have not had Lunchables since, like, third or fourth grade. And you were like, I have Lunchables all the time. It's delicious. And Mike's been inspired to eat Lunchables from time to time as a result of your eating of Lunchables. Do you feel weird about buying Lunchables?
Absolutely not. You know, people give me a look, and I don't care. I'm serious. I don't care. I usually get to Tedeschi's over there on Belmont from here in Brockton.
Enjoying your Capri Sun that comes with it?
It comes with everything. It's a complete package. And you get a little dessert. You can't beat it. That's probably the best deal in Brockton.
Outside of Shoe City Screens?
Outside of Shoe City Screens. You know what? I think Lunchables should sponsor Shoe City Screens.
Maybe they will.
They will. They should do it next year because everyone should get a Lunchable walking in.
You ever see that fake Lunchables commercial?
Oh, it's so good.
No.
It's a shame we can't play it.
We can't play it. It's too explicit.
It is,
to play on the air. But there's a fake Lunchables commercial that's pretty good. What else was I going to ask you besides the Lunchables question moments ago?
About Step Up?
Something about Step Up, but I don't know what more I could add to.
Oh, maybe Trumita yelling at me yesterday?
No, it wasn't about Trumita yelling at you. Unless you'd like to elaborate on Trumita yelling at you.
Honestly, I don't remember why. I think I interrupted her.
You were talking over her during her show.
Oh, heaven forbid. Heaven forbid her guests talk while she's talking on her show. That'd be blasphemous, right?
It got rough for a second.
Yeah, she got rough. But, you know, one thing I'm good at, for some reason, I think I get along with everyone pretty well. But when I get on someone's nerves, I tend to make them go extremely crazy. I don't know why.
I think with Trumita,
you
piss her off. You know you're pissing her off, and as you're pissing her off for her, your own amusement, you try to go as far as you can, knowing that it will be better within a few days.
Yes, you know I love when Trumita says she's done with me. I'm like, actually, she said it on that. She said, "Newbie, I'm done with you." I'm like, "No, you're not."
You and Trumita are very good friends off the air. We should mention.
I've been knowing Trumita since I was 13 years old. Me and Trumita go way back. Brockton High School, Yellow IRC, Bridgewater State, the whole nine.
Have you guys ever had a time for you guys have not spoken to each other for weeks at a time due to hostility amongst you two?
That's a yes.
No. No. We've never gotten one argument.
All right, well, yeah.
Not one.
Once again, we're chatting with Newbie Rizzo. Newbie, what day are they showing Step Up at the Shoe City Screens Festival and where?
Showing Step Up Saturday, August 3rd. Like I said before, it's the last time we're showing it over in the Brockton area because of two reasons. Number one, you know, we showed it in Brockton a total of 8 times. And number two, we're working on distribution. So we really want to focus on putting Step Up on TV for people can watch it on their TV sets and instead of live viewing. So we're working on the distribution part.
And Step Up does have a deal to be on television this fall, correct?
It's going to be on television this fall. The network, once it's everything signed and everything, I'll make the announcement, but we'll be on national TV in the fall. The announcement is going to be coming out very, very soon. But okay. I'm really excited about it.
Well, congratulations on that. We'll have to have you on the program before Step Up makes it. It's network television premiere, Step Up, a documentary produced by Newbie Rizzo about fatherhood. You mentioned this is the final time that Step Up will be shown in the Brockton area. It's the 8th time that it's been shown in the Brockton area. You've made documentaries in the past about the healthcare system in the United States, relationships, fatherhood. What is the next subject you will tackle when it comes to your documentary filmmaking?
Well, just finished one documentary. Actually, finished it up last Friday, called The Bridge. Worked on that with Manny Garcia. Half an hour documentary. Very, very powerful documentary. It's about I'm not going to take the credit for this one. It's Manny's idea. I was a director and editor. It's about, you know, how hip hop and education need to be, that marriage needs to happen, and how so many people now connect with music. Let's incorporate music with education, because that seems to be getting out of education now. So we did some filming with Manny, and we did some filming over at Surefire Entertainment. We did some filming at the Champion Charter School. We interviewed Manny over at Brockton High School, and it's just a powerful half an hour documentary. The next one, New Productions, is working on where I'm also the producer and the director, along with Will Madero and Hakeem Hill, is about gun culture. And that one's called The Culture. And it talks about the gun culture in the urban, suburban neighborhoods, the environment, results, and motives of gun culture. Very, very powerful film. The stories that I'm already getting are incredible. And that's what, another reason why we're going to stop doing public screenings for step-ups, because we want to work on the distribution process, but also really dive into this next document of the culture, which will take about 6 months, and we'll finish it in the fall. But I'll tell you what, Peter, you know, once I start a documentary, you know, you can ask everyone this. I'm completely zoned in. I'm locked in. I become the documentary. You know, I was joking around last summer, you know, the only people I was attracted to, I guess, was girls or kids doing this fatherhood documentary.
Oddly enough, now he loves chicks with guns.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so it's really like, it's like I completely locked myself into this documentary. So I'm excited, you know, a lot of inspiring stories. And that's what it's all about, is telling people stories.
This is an objective look at the gun culture in America as well. Do you have any position that you take in the documentary?
No, I'm not going to take any position. But having said that, without taking a position, you take a position, if you know what I'm saying. If you watch Step Up or if you watch the drug documentary, even though I'm not necessarily in it, well, actually, Silence, I should say I'm not. The drug documentary, I'm actually in. But the fatherhood documentary, if you watch it, you kind of get a perspective of where the director's coming from. You kind of get an idea of where I sway. I sway towards more personal responsibility, step up, and do what you got to do. The gun culture, you'll understand where I sway on this one.
Do you have any thoughts on gun control and whatnot in America?
My thought is this. The more I think about it, we don't have a problem with legal guns in this country as much as illegal guns. And where is it coming from, and why is it feeding into our cities, our communities? In terms of legal guns, my problem is that I think there's too much gray area in the law. So you get unfortunate situations like Trayvon Martin. And I've said before, you know, Trayvon Martin is no longer with us, but that law is still alive, and that will kill somebody else if we don't attack that law.
What law?
The Stand Your Ground law.
See, that's a very controversial law that did not actually come into play in the actual trial of George Zimmerman. However, it was mentioned to the jury prior to the trial.
Yes, that is true. That Stand Your Ground law, that did play a part, and that's one of the reasons why he became innocent.
No, that has nothing to do with why he became innocent.
I think it actually didn't
come up in the trial.
I think the justice system would have failed if George Zimmerman was found guilty. Because under the letter of the law and self-defense and so forth, it mirrors what that law is.
You should interview Ted Nugent for this gun culture documentary.
Yes, I want to interview Teddy O. Nugent. You know, so
Uncle Teddy,
Ted? Yeah, Ted, come on, man. What's up? Talk to me. Give it.
Certainly garnered this radio station enough attention last week. 7:47 here on AM 1460, the new WXBR. You're listening to the Metro South Morning Show. Want to mention to the listeners one more time that the Shoe City Screens Festival is this weekend in the city of Brockton. Friday night at the Shoe City Screens Festival is at the Buckley Performing Arts Center on the campus of Massasoit Community College. Then Saturday night at Joe Angelo's Cafe. More information can be found where, once again, newbie?
BrocktonArts.com or on Facebook, just type in Shoe City Screens.
BrocktonArts.com or on Facebook, just type in Shoe City Screens. Newbie, I want to thank you so much for joining us here.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Pava. Thank you so much.
I want to thank you for joining us on the Metro South Morning Show this morning. We're going to step aside for a quick breather. We'll take a quick look at weather and traffic. We'll return. We'll do more of the program. Newbie has to leave us. Newbie, thank you so much.
Batman, little Batman, big Batman, Batman, Batman.
If you see Newbie Ritzo at the Shoe City Screens Fest this weekend, ask him to do his Birdman impression, and then he'll show you his Birdman dance. Stick with us here on WXBR.